we'll go ahead and get started if that's all right. We're a couple of minutes here before, but kind of customary in the area here to kind of read the obituary, and I'll start out with that. Thomas George Wright of Garden City, Missouri, was born April 30th, 1943, the son of George and Inez Waldschmidt Wright Brandt in Iowa City, Iowa. He departed this life on Saturday, June the 16th, 2018 at the Pleasant Hill Health and Rehab at the age of 75 years, 1 month, and 16 days. Tom graduated from Iowa City High School in 1962. He served 30 years in the U.S. Marine Corps from 1963 to 1993, retiring as Master Gunnery Sergeant. He was always a hard worker and followed this with 18 years at the Walmart in Harrisonville until his retirement in 2011. Thomas married Susan Bergeron in 1966 in San Diego, California, and they later divorced. In October of 1992, he married Pauline Lois Greenwood Murray. Besides his parents, he was preceded to death by his stepfather, Elmer Brandt, and a niece, Deborah Mathis. Tom is survived by his wife, Pauline, his daughters, Christine and Cynthia of California, a stepson, Kevin Murray, and his wife, Cindy of Florida, a sister, Pat Mathis, and husband, Tom of Marion, Iowa, a nephew, Darren Mathis, and his wife, Cindy of South Dakota, two great nieces, Marion and Kate Mathis of South Dakota, three stepsisters, a stepbrother, many cousins and friends. I'm going to read a set of scripture here before we play the first song out of Ecclesiastes, and I just think kind of describe Tom a little bit here, especially in the last part of this, but it comes from Ecclesiastes 3, 1 through 12. It says, "There's a time for everything and a season for every activity under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones and a time to gather them, a time to embrace and a time to refrain, a time to search and a time to give up, a time to keep and a time to throw away." You guys will, this kind of describes everything you're going through. You laughed, you mourned, you're going to be going through things of keeping and throwing away. It's just kind of ironic. Scripture never changes. A time to tear and a time to mend, a time to be silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, and a time of war and a time for peace. And Tom experienced that himself with the 30 years in the military. And in verse 9 it says, "What does the worker gain from his toil? I have seen the burden God has laid on men. He has made everything beautiful in its time. He has also set eternity in the hearts of men, yet they cannot fathom what God has done from beginning to end." I know this is where I kind of, with Tom, with his working in the military for 30 years and at Walmart, I know that there is nothing better for man than to be happy and do good while they live, that everyone may eat, drink, and find satisfaction in all his toil. This is the gift of God.
You to shine.
just got a kind of a short sermon, short devotion, short thought here. I'm just staying in the book of Ecclesiastes. In Ecclesiastes 7:2, Solomon writes, "It is better to go to the house of mourning than to go to the house of feasting. For death is the destiny of every man, and the living should take this to heart." If you know anything about Solomon, if you know anything about the book of Ecclesiastes and who Solomon was King David's son. And when he became king at a young man, God asked him, said, "What would you like? I can give you anything you want." And of all the things Solomon could ask for, he asked for wisdom on how to rule the people. And because he asked for wisdom, God blessed him with wealth and everything that anybody can imagine. I mean, the finest garments and everything God blessed him with. And as he grew older and through time, he drifted away from God, and everybody knows about his lifestyle. But at the end of his life, he writes the book of Ecclesiastes. Basically, it is a looking back on his life. He may have been at the time when he knew that he was not going to live much longer, and he was looking back, and he wrote the book of Ecclesiastes, and he says there in 7:2, it is better to go to the house of mourning. And the reason why he said this is because he knew that this is where people reflect. They look back on their life, and when you're at a wedding, when you're at a birthday party, when you're at a birth of a child, you really don't think about your life. You don't think about things that are important. You're there to celebrate. But it's time like this when we can reflect on our own life, when we can reflect on what's important to us. And Solomon knew that. He's like, this is the time when you need to reflect on your own life, what is important to you, what relationships are important to you, and what's important in your life. Sunday at church, they had a video, a Father's Day video, and it's like, you know, things you never hear a father say. And one of them, of course, I have a teenage son, and one of them was like, "Oh, you've known a project has been due for 4 weeks, and you just now started it today? You're fantastic. You never heard a father say that. You never had heard a father say, when are you going to get another tattoo?" You know, just had a lot of list of things, you know, that the father, you never hear a father say, you know, to his teenage daughter, "I really like that boy. I think you should date him." So it was kind of a funny thing, but you know, when you get to the end of your life, you never really hear too many people say, "I wish I spent more time at work." You never hear people say, "I wish I would have done this," or "I wish I would have done that." It's usually, "I wish I had spent more time with my family. I wish I would have taken more time to cure that relationship with that friend or that family member." And that's what I just want to think about today. I just want to leave with that thought today is, what's important in your life? Do you need to make a phone call to somebody? Do you need to mend a relationship? Do you just need to call somebody that you haven't talked to in a long time and say, "Hey, you know, just thinking about you, and I just wanted to say that I was thinking about you." And there's a poem that I like to read sometimes and to whenever things, you know, kind of get me down. It's called "The Dash" by Linda Ellis. And you may have heard this. If you've been to very many funerals, you may have heard this or may have heard it at one time or another, but it says, "I read of a man who stood to speak at the funeral of a friend. He referred to the dates on the tombstone from the beginning to the end. He noted that first came the date of birth and spoke of the following date with tears, but said what mattered most was the dash between those years. For that dash represents all the time they spent alive on earth, and now only those who love them know what that little line is worth. For it not matters how much we own, the cars, the house, the cash. What matters is how we lived and loved and how we spend our dash." So think about this long and hard. Are there things you'd like to change? For you never know how much time is left that can still be rearranged. To be less quick to anger and show appreciation more and love the people in our lives like we've never loved before. If we treat each other with respect and more often wear a smile, remembering that this special dash might only last a little while. So when your eulogy is being read with your life's actions to rehash, would you be proud of the things that they have to say about you, your life, and how you lived your dash?" And in Ecclesiastes, after Solomon wrote all of this, this is what he says at the end of Ecclesiastes in chapter 12. He says, "Now all of this has been heard. Here's the conclusion of the matter. Fear God and keep his commandments, for this is the whole duty of man."
sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear. The hour I first
We just thank you for your grace. We thank you for your love, your compassion, your forgiveness. We just thank you for the life of Tom, and we thank you for the memories that we have, Father, that we can just hold on to, that we can laugh about, that we can share, that our tears will turn to laughter in the coming days, Father. Just put your love around us and just let us know that you do care for us. We just ask you to just be with our trip as we go to the cemetery, that we can just honor Tom one more time with the military service and give him the recognition that he deserves for his service to this country, Father. We just ask you to just be with us and give us a safe trip. In your son's name we pray. Amen.